Good morning, welcome home to Mailer's Landing. I'm Sue, and we are here in Growing Zone 6B in New England. And I am celebrating a tiny little paperwork victory that I had this morning and feeling pretty good about it. And then I saw my lemon plant. I think about this lemon tree and I think about redemption arcs. I know, it's corny. She lost all her leaves. Things went sideways. She looked awful for a minute there. Look at all these buds.
That. We have a whole bunch of buds on there and I'm gonna leave them. You know, this is our indoor lemon. She smells fantastic when she blooms.
And I'm gonna do a little bit of pruning sometime after she gets her leaves back. I'll see which branches the leaves grew back on, which they didn't, and I'll prune back the ones that didn't grow back. So yeah, ain't that an analogy and a half, right? Let me show you something else super cool. I bought these fig starts last year and I never did get them in the ground and I brought them in. They were pretty frozen and they looked like sticks.
Hello, figgy babies. Got new growth, beautiful buds. Both of them just look so freaking good.
The girls are laying again, thank goodness. I've been thinking a lot about change and rejuvenation. More than anything, these have been huge themes in my life lately. I found myself changing the orientation of furniture in a room and like really just feeling the energy shift. It's freaking fantastic. So I've been doing a lot of that. Systems I've put in place are working pretty good so far. Let me show you the kitchen. The kitchen's still looks pretty good. The biggest takeaway for me from the lemon plant and the fig tree is the consistency of cycles. We have more sun, we have eggs, we have a lemon plant that we thought was dead regenerating. We have fig plants that we thought were dead coming back for it. We're really not that far away from spring, right? We're gonna start winter sowing next month. What I'm really trying to say is that often when systems and habitat become inviting and unstressed, living things do well. They stand a better chance of recovering, of thriving, of becoming stable. And that's what I'm trying to do with my surroundings right now.
Thank you, ladies.
Because, you know, I'm a living thing. And when I look at these, what I think is, I can keep starting again. I can keep starting again, and I can celebrate starting again over and over and over. It's important. I'm going to celebrate these little victories, every one of them. For me, it's super easy to get into a rut where I feel like it's always been that way and it's never gonna change, especially when I'm really, really sad. And I'm working hard on not being really, really sad right now. But the truth of the matter is if that lemon tree can come back to life, so can I, right? I've done it before and I'm gonna do it again. And I've crumbled in between. I mean, comes out of their 30s factory fresh. What I really wanted to tell you about is I am about to embark on a project. So I started a few weeks ago documenting what is on my kitchen table weekly. There is always a lot of stuff on this kitchen table. This is very much what I like to think of as a working kitchen. What I mean by a working kitchen is that there's almost always something happening in this room. Whether it be soaking beans or making bread, or putting a trunk together, or repotting plants, or staging for some kind of a building project. And the table, I'm sure I've described this to you before as a way station or a loading station. The table is a place where things going places start. I've got a whole bunch of stuff here. It's going to the basement. We'll talk about that in a minute. I'm going to fess up to creating doom boxes on the table occasionally because the biggest category of stuff that gets left on that table is stuff I don't want to forget, To my shock, today there are no hand tools on here. As of yesterday, there was a set of ATV shocks on top of here too. But by looking at this kitchen table, I can really see not only where we're coming from, but where we're going to, because things accumulate on here that are lined up to go into a project or to start a project. Mail, of course, unopened packages, of course. But today, for example, I've got a whole bag of saved seeds because sometime this week I want to go through here, set some of these aside to start in February. Here, come on over. I'll show you what's going on today. This is today's table. And we have another manure to put away. We have jars and bottles and a container that are going to go down to the basement and get put away down there. We have the seeds that I showed you. We have mail, and my friend Bryna sent us some tea. And believe me when I tell you, this is a mild morning of kitchen table. There's almost nothing on it. Things that have taken up space on top of my kitchen table include, there was a coyote pelt that was being tanned and a lot of salt, a variety of carboys in a variety of stages of brewing. Thanksgiving, whatever doesn't have to be refrigerated winds up on top of the table the week before. It's a busy place. So yeah, there's a metric ton of moving pieces. If we're being honest, that's how I roll. And I'm gonna start not just taking still photos, but doing little tiny tours of the kitchen table as we go forward. And then, because context is where the magic happens, I'd like to look at these images all together and read it like tarot cards, perhaps. Look into its glamour. Cut it open and look at it like the Hardy specs. I think what I'm gonna try and do is put them together into some sort of a time lapse at the end. Something else that I wanna do as the year goes on and I'm documenting the kitchen table, I wanna keep track of what things are there, what feels regular, and how it naturally evolves. So I'm gonna be keeping an eye on this. I'm a curiosity-driven person. And I'm going to follow this curiosity. So you should come along with me. Here's a little bit of footage that I took over the last couple of weeks. Remember when we talked about like the depot that the table has become? Already, I have a collection of jars and tools and a stash of tool-like stuff that doesn't fit in the box with the tools. And enough menorahs for everyone. Good morning, it is the 3rd of January 2023 and this is the kitchen table. Good morning.
Good morning.
It's what, 13 days to your birthday?
13 days.
13 days! Okay, so, yep, these are, my husband is an armorer. These are lance parts. These are lance parts. Okay, jars are still there. Haven't gotten that downstairs. Ooh, canned air has joined us. Okay. Is this silly? Will you come along with me on this journey? Because I feel like it's going to be super interesting. But yeah, so I'm going to start posting those here and there so you can get a look at it. Anyway, I hope you join me on this journey and I will catch you up soon. Take care.